Thank you. Thank all of you. You've been wonderful. Yes. All right. Calm down. All right. Thank you. Our very warm welcome from you all tonight. Let's extend that welcome to the greatest band in the history of music, Santino and the Noel Show Band. Yes. They are awesome. They are, as the NWO would say, too sweet. Right there. Very good. Yeah, they're just the best. Lots of stuff going on in the news I think we need to talk about. It turns out, I think some of you probably saw this, that Senator Mitch McConnell suffered a stroke, or at least he seems to have suffered a stroke, giving a political speech. That's true. A lot of people were concerned, but then concerns were eased. President Biden apparently called McConnell asking if he was okay, and McConnell said he didn't have a stroke, that he was just drunk. That is true. That's very true. I guess he's just a regular frat boy. Boys will be boys. He then extended that statement to put people's mind even more at ease. He said that Dianne Feinstein had him rolling on E. Apparently she's got the X if you're into taking drugs. That's right. Find me in the club. Very good. Whew. All right, anyway, Hunter Biden, that lovable scamp, that globetrotter extraordinaire, he's in the news again, as per usual. Can't keep himself out of trouble. So apparently, Hunter Biden, his legal team has decided to walk away from his plea deal. That's true. Apparently, the Biden legal team demanded total immunity, and the judge was just not going to give them that. The judge said she drew the line at the request where the Biden legal team wanted immunity for Hunter walking the Biden family dog around like a vacuum cleaner back in 72. It was not going to be in the terms of the deal. They had to draw the line somewhere, so they're going to go back to the negotiating table, see if they can hammer something out. Well, enough about this politics slop, as Ralphie's dad from A Christmas Story would like to say. Let's talk a little bit about celebrity gossip here. It's been rumored that legendary Tampa Bay Buccaneers and New England Patriots quarterback Tom Brady is dating Kim Kardashian. That is nuts. Just in case. You were questioning if Tom Brady's life was better than yours. He really wants to, you know, dot those final I's and cross those final T's, however it works, right? Not to be outdone, the one and only Kanye West said, you know what, Kim, fine. If you're going to date the greatest athlete when it comes to the NFL, I'm going to date the greatest character in the history of sci-fi. That is right. Kanye West, and this is not a doctored photo, has been cited dating Darth Vader. There's the lovely couple right there. And I don't know about you, I think that is a handsome couple. I would totally invite that couple out for drinks and or a spirited game of Boggle. Right there, invite him over for game night. That is right. Whew. Anywho, we got a great show in store. We're gonna visit a very interesting episode of my past. We'll all check that out, have some excitement with that. You're gonna see a very familiar and lovable talk show host, and that's not me. Also, we're going to have a very nice interview with Patrick Stewart, Captain Picard himself. Patrick Stewart is here. That's right. And also, musical guest, he's not quite as good as Santino, but he's darn good, Japanese keyboard legend and music producer Tetsuya Komuro is also on the show. That's right. All right, we will see you right after these exciting commercial messages. Play us out, Santino!
Come on, sunset. この頃のシャンプーは進化しています。
リンスもコンディショナーも入ったシェイクするシャンプ
ー、フルナが新しい、
カネボーアサシャン新発売。
It was a decade in the making. Now it's a star-studded, action-packed, prime-time spectacular.
Did you see that movie, Spartacus? It'll be a lot like that.
With Bob Dylan and an all-star band, Bill Murray, and 10 years worth of stuff you can only get from Dave. Late Night's 10th Anniversary Special, tonight after Cheers.
Welcome back. Before we get to our first guest tonight, I thought I would do something fun. One of my favorite TV shows back in the day was Late Night with Conan O'Brien. And on Conan, he would have a lever that when he pulled it, it would play random clips from Walker, Texas Ranger. And I thought, man, that is awesome. I have no idea how you find such a thing. But apparently in Japan, they made quite a few of those products. And some of them found their way into backdoor channels in the United States. What I found when I took Santino to GameStop was this Pokeball, and I thought it was just a normal toy, but it's really weird. When you hit it, it randomly plays clips of the unofficial Japanese sequel to Bloodsport, Yasuaki Karada's Blood Fight right here. Now, this movie is deeply underrated. It was advertised during an episode of Monday Nitro before Hulk Hogan fought Lex Luger. Check that match out. It's very, very good. But, you know, this was really cool. I was just messing around with it, and it plays random clips of Blood Fight. So I thought we would check this out in case you haven't seen the unofficial sequel to the greatest movie ever made, Bloodsport. Let's check out what the Blood Fight Pokeball has in store for us right now.
Hi. Mr. Chen.
Hi, cousin. Yeah. I haven't seen you for a long time.
Yeah. Eat anything you like.
Yeah? I wouldn't feed the shit to a dog.
What do you say?
I'm just talking to you, old man.
Mr. Han. Hey, your wife has left.
She called me. She's going to ask for a divorce.
I see.
Darn, that's kind of an unpleasant situation, both for the food truck owner and then also for Kai, apparently, whose wife is apparently wanting a divorce. That's some unfortunate news that comes in after a morning jog. Anyway, let's see what else we got here on the Blood Fight Ball. The little girl is, she's quite talented and apparently equipped to spay and neuter well-dressed Japanese street toughs. Those bad guys are all dressed impeccably. I need to talk to their tailor. Anyway, let's see what else we got here.
Not bad.
I like that guy. I like that. That guy's really cool. Not only does he give you a begrudging acknowledgement, he's also a cool bald guy with glasses, and I definitely identify with him. So right on. Let's see what else we got here in the Blood Fight Ball. I guess that is an important lesson not to have cornflakes before you enter a full contact underground martial arts tournament. So no cornflakes and milk before the kumite. See what else we got here.
You're going to win. Hey! Yeah!
wheelchair genius.
Listen to all.
Come on. Don't you know who we are? Hey, man.
What are you doing?
Wow, that is a guy who definitely knows what he wants and is well-dressed and is not afraid to tell you how he feels. Anyway, let's see what else we got in the old blood fight ball here. There's gonna be a rhinoplasty bill that's gonna get passed around here. Anywho, let's see what else we got here. All right. Cake by the pound. Quality martial arts. Let's see what else we got.
Wow! I'm a master! You teach me how to do all these things, Sensei? If I knew how to do this, I could beat the shit out of anybody!
That right there is a motivated student who will beat the shit out of anybody. That's some good, good stuff. Anywho, let's see what else we got in store. That is too heartwarming a note to continue on. So we'll be right back with our first guest, which is going to be a fun situation, a little special. Stay tuned right after these messages.
Tonight,
this is where it all comes together, folks.
Robert Urich joins Dave.
And here's how to order.
Watch Late Show with David Letterman tonight.
You're really something.
新発行度 採用.
Okay.
キリッと締まって 飲み口ドライ.
Dry, dry.
Kirin Dry. 新発売.
Welcome back. Welcome back. Santino, what are you eating there?
Are those... Sweet and spicy sweet chili.
Are those Doritos?
Yes.
You know who used to sell Doritos, Santino?
Who?
Late night talk show host Jay Leno. That's very true. He used to sell Doritos. You know, Santino, this is actually pretty interesting. Not only do I host a late night talk show, I've actually also been on a late night talk show. I used to follow David Letterman back in the mid-90s. I was on the Late Late Show with Tom Snyder. Santino, do you think you'd like to see that and think the viewers might want to check that out?
Sure.
All right, why not? So why don't we, rather than having me interview someone, show you guys a clip of me being interviewed on the Late Late Show with Tom Snyder. Here it is right now.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Tonight on the Late Late Show with Tom Snyder, our special on the mentally disturbed continues with small-time talk show host Noel. Noel, how are you?
I'm great, Tom. Thank you for having me on the show. I'm a big fan of your low-key intellectual discussions on late-night television.
Noel, the first time we met, I saw you rummaging in the dumpsters behind my supermarket.
Yes, that's right, Tom.
Noel, let me be blunt. What were you looking for in those dumpsters?
Eggnog, Tom. You know, there's a lot of preservatives in eggnog, and they take the eggnog out of the store fridges in January, but I have been assured that that eggnog is good until at least late March, early April. That's what Regis told me.
Noel, I see you have a few scars on your face.
Yes, that's right, Tom. I've got a pretty nasty one here on my chin.
I understand. Is there a story behind that scar?
Yes, Tom. Actually, I passed out watching the 1992 presidential debate and hit the corner of a table and kind of split my chin open right here.
Noel, you talk about the 1992 presidential debate and election. Do you feel that Ross Perot's success was due to his rugged good looks and sex appeal?
Yes, I do, Tom. You know, soccer and wine moms on my block would be in heated ecstasy whenever he would appear on TV. It was a rare sight to see a television set that did not have underwear thrown at it when he came on the screen.
No, Noel, we're talking about scars. Of course, we're going to have to talk about the scar on your eyebrow and the story behind it relating to the time you hosted the Oscars.
Yes, of course. You know, that Oscar situation, I remember it. I remember it like it was yesterday. Yeah. And can we please talk about the current crop of movies stinking up the nation's theaters right now? Yeah, Problem Child? More like Problem Getting My Ticket Refunded. Yeah. Oh, and how about this one? Ghost? I mean, what the hell is that? Yeah, Whoopi Goldberg? More like Whoopi Cushion. Yeah. Yeah, take that, society.
Whoopi's name out of your f***ing mouth.
What is it? Is that Ted Danson?
Keep Whoopi's name.
I'm a huge fan of Cheers. And oh my God, does he have a knife?
Danson.
Ow. Oh, he got me good. Somebody call my mom and wife. There's not gonna be any Christmas this year.
Noel, I must say, I have interviewed sick and disturbed individuals, the likes of David Duke, Charles Manson, and Roger Ebert. But I must say, out of them all, you are by far the worst.
Why, thank you, Tom. That endorsement means a lot to me.
Well, that's all we have for tonight's show. Tomorrow, our guests will be David Letterman and Beatrice Arthur. Special thanks to our sponsor, Jordache Jeans, and drive safely and stay tuned for our following program, the Share Makeup Infomercial. Good night, everybody.
This is CBS.
Look out, America. Dave's going prime time. Catch Dave playing around at the drive-thru and cruising with Zsa Zsa. The Late Show with David Letterman video special.
And remember, special refers to the time period, not the content.
Monday at 10, 9 Central.
All right. Welcome back. Our first guest is Patrick Stewart, one of my all-time favorite actors from one of my all-time favorite TV shows, Star Trek The Next Generation. Check him out in action in this exciting clip right now.
Next time on Star Trek The Next Generation.
Bring that ship back at once.
I've lost power.
The captain struggles to save a runaway shuttlecraft.
May you all do your best.
And Wesley meets the ultimate Starfleet test. Now, both face the toughest challenge of their lives.
Pull up hard!
6 seconds to impact.
I'm gonna crash.
On Star Trek, The Next Generation.
All right, here he is, Patrick Stewart. Play him in, Santino. All right, Patrick. How are you doing? You know, I am a huge fan of you and Star Trek The Next Generation.
But of course you are, Noel. You bespectacled charlatan. I'm doing splendid. I feel as though I was Lady Macbeth before a swath of Huguenots.
So, Patrick, what was it like working with Michael Dorn? You know, I loved him as Worf.
Ah, that Klingon fellow. His forehead and ridges had the handsome sagacity and symmetry of Buckingham Palace.
Yes. Patrick, I really, really liked the episode where you turned into a Borg. How did you go to the bathroom in that robot suit?
I was outfitted in the most regal of diapers. My number one had the opulence and extravagance of our number two.
I see. You know, Patrick, I minored in Soviet history when I was at college. I really enjoyed you in the miniseries Fall of Eagles, where you played Lenin.
I was furious over the casting choices. I nearly walked out when John Goodman was not cast as Krupskaya. Only he could capture the girthitude and wit of Lenin's wife.
Okay.
You know, Noel, on the set of Fall of Eagles, the director would have me look at a series of lights to frame the shot. In reality, there were four lights, but he insisted that there were five lights. I would yell at him, "There are four lights!" But do you know, Noel, he kept insisting that there were five lights. And after a series of berating by him for a very brief moment, I actually believed that there were five lights.
Okay. Well, Patrick, this has been fun. I think we're going to have to wrap up our interview. And we will be right back with our musical guest, Tetsuya Komuro, after this. Yes, Patrick, why is your mom?
My mother is a wonderful woman. How dare you question her wit and sagacity? And there are four lights!
Regain this. 24-hour. 戦えますか?
戦えますか?
新ビタミン drink. Regain. 三強から新登場.
Welcome back. It's been a crazy and interesting show thus far. Our musical guest is one of the most well-known producers and keyboard players in Japan. Here he is, Tetsuya Komuro. He's not as good as Santino, who also plays the keyboard, but you know, he's pretty good. Let's check him out right now.
Yeah.
Wow, Santino, it has been quite the show tonight. What do you got there, my friend?
So I found this in the Pokeball in the...
What is it?
It's a Dragon Ball that shows very serious Dragon Ball
clips. It's a baseball that shows Dragon Ball clips.
Serious
Dragon Ball clips. Santino, if it plays a random Dragon Ball clip, and I'm a big fan of Dragon Ball, I just do your thing. Activate the ball, man. That was definitely the unique Dragon Ball clip. Actually, that was the most unique Dragon Ball clip I think I've ever seen. Anywho, that's all we've got time for today. Make sure you tune in next time to The Knoll Show.